Let's go to the new environment and explore it. This is the main page through which we can enter to the new environment or the Cloud Foundry environment. Let's scroll down and go to new environment. Let's click on this one. It is opening the new environment. This is the user interface of new environment. We will see all these options one by one. Here you can see the name of the sub account. This is our sub account that is being used inside the new environment. In the system status section, you can see that we have Java, HTML5, database system, and enhanced disaster recovery options. In the Java section, you can see all the Java applications that are deployed in the new environment. In the HTML5 section, you can see that we have one application that is already deployed. In the database system, we have no database as of now. And in the enhanced disaster recovery, this option is not enabled. If I scroll down, I can see the name of the sub-account on the left-hand side. And in this section, I can see what type of services I can use in the new environment. So let's click on it and check it out. Here you can see that a lot of services are being provided inside the new environment. Let's go to the top and check some of them. You have service available for the Git. You can store your source code in the Git repository and it is enabled. Remember, we are in the trial account. On this side, we have HTML5 application. We can develop and run HTML5 application, that is SAP UI5 applications. Here, we can manage the lifecycle of Java applications using a REST API. We have Java debugging service enabled. We have monitoring. We can monitor Java and HANA applications using this service. Then we have OData provisioning available. Through this, we can access the data of on-premise system using OData services in the cloud platform. Then we have remote data sync available to synchronize data between remote databases and a cloud SAP HANA database. We have SAP HANA service to create and consume SAP HANA databases. We have SAP Web IDE full stack available. Let's check what is inside it. If I click on it, it will show that the service is enabled. It means that I can use it. It is the description of the service. And on the right hand side, you can see the availability. Here you can see that this SAP Web IDE full stack is not available for the Cloud Foundry environment. It is only available inside the new environment. And these are the data centers that are currently hosting the SAP Web IDE full stack. At the bottom, we have documentation related to this. Let's go back. Scroll down. We have document service to store and manage your documents. We have mobile services. These are currently not enabled. We have SAP build. As we saw earlier, we can create prototype for client demo. We have forms by Adobe. Then we have business rules. We have UI theme designer. We have connectivity. We can establish connection between cloud application and on-premise systems. So these were the services that are being provided inside the new environment. Let's go back to our overview page. Let's check what is here. In this application section, we can see there are three types of application that we can deploy. Inside the Java application, we can deploy Java applications. Inside the HTML5 application, we can deploy SAP UI5 applications. I have already deployed one application over here, and it is in the started state. In the coming tutorial, we will see how to deploy this. Inside HANA Access application, we can deploy HANA-based applications. This subscription is used to subscribe any services that were created any sub-account. For example, if I click on new subscription, then from here I can select the sub-account. This is our sub-account. So if I click on this one, then I can select my application to which I want to subscribe. As of now, I will cancel it. This services section we had already explored when we were inside the overview. In the solution, we can deploy the MTA-based application. MTA is a multi-target applications that are created using different technologies, but they have same lifecycle development. In the SAP HANA / SAP ASE section, we can deploy HANA-based system. We can create new database system. It is collecting the information. As of now, we are inside the trial account, and in the trial account, we do not have any HANA service available. So let's close this and move on. Inside the connectivity, through the cloud connector, you can access the data of Business Suite inside the new environment. Here you can see that I have already deployed one cloud connector and it is available. In the security part, you can manage the security of your applications. You can add the users that will be using these applications, and you can manage the roles over here. Inside the repository section, we have Git repositories available. Git is basically a tool that is used to store the versions of the source code. It is a very popular tool and it is used for version management. So here we can see that I have stored my application's code inside the Git repository. And in this useful links, you can check the documentation. You can go to SAP Store or SAP Community. Inside the legal information, you have privacy documentation, you have terms of use, then you have copyright. On the upper right corner, you have this give feedback. You can give feedback to SAP about how you feel about the new environment. And the second option is the user menu. From here, you can check the information about yourself. You can change your settings. You can see what account is assigned to me. You can contact SAP. You can log off your new environment. And the last option is help. If you click on this button, you can see that it is providing an interactive help. If you ever get confused, like what are these options, then you can click on this question mark and then you can explore these options. For any particular screen, it will give you the documentation. So that was it for the new environment.